Hello, hello, welcome back to another video on the channel where healing and spiritual growth are front and center. This video shout out goes to Jason Humber. Thank you for your continued support. And the topic we're going to dive into today has to do with a little bit more about that spiritual energy transfer as we answer this question. As an empath, what does it mean when I can't read someone's energy or it feels foggy? Let me explain something here, empath. Now, you super empaths are going to know exactly what I'm talking about. But empaths who are still waking up and still learning, I want you to understand that once God wakes you up and you start to learn how to sense and decipher all of the different energies around you in the spiritual realm, you will never stop reading anyone's energy. That's just not going to happen. You will always be able to. That's something the enemy does not want anyone to know. The enemy wanted to keep that hidden for a reason. Let's think about it. How many narcissistic abuse situations did we find ourselves in over and over and over again? Because when we were younger, we knew about the spiritual realm. We knew it was there. We just didn't yet know how real it was or is, okay? That's a better way to put it, because it is very real. And as we were younger, we knew, okay, because we could sense it. We didn't know what it was then. Remember, we had a long way to go. And so we end up going through those life's lessons, okay, is what they are. And as we get closer and closer to God's reality, as the enemy is trying to throw all those fiery darts, okay, and the main reason behind narcissistic abuse is not just to, as I say often, to keep people traumatized, but also clinging to their childhood, and also so they don't make it to God's reality. Okay, that's very important to remember. But empaths, you will not ever stop reading other people's energy, because you will always know. That intuition is going to kick in. That intuition that got put to sleep when all of us were under that heavy cloud of cognitive dissonance for many, many years. Okay, and the purpose behind that is to keep us asleep so we don't ever reconnect with that spiritual body and reignite that intuition. But actually, God's the one that does that when he wakes us up. So I want to point out another very important point in this question, where when you said it feels foggy. Now, let me explain something. That is still the empath reading energy. You walk into an environment and it feels foggy, that is also the negative energy. And I speak about that in other videos, but it's relevant to this, because that foggy that you're sensing, that is the negative energy. And there are some very important points that I want to point out as to why the devil and his flying monkeys, aka the narcissist, demon spirit, they don't want you to know about that. They don't want you to be able to sense it, because they want to be able to drag you right there with them. All right, we have that demon of negativity. So you walk into an environment and it feels foggy, which also means it feels stuffy, okay? Stuffy, or, muggy, if you will. And it has nothing to do with the thermostat or, the weather outside or anything like that. But you walk in and you can sense, okay? And a lot of times it's accompanied by that low vibration. I speak more about that, the Earth's low rumble, over on Patreon, because it goes hand in hand with that negative energy. Remember something. That negativity, all that negative energy, that is what fuels this earth, okay? That is what the demonic forces feed on the most, okay? So that is designed to try to turn you into the same kind of vibration, that low vibration I speak about, that negativity, is to try to, if you can almost feel that fogginess, that negative energy, and you're, that means you're sensing it, okay? That's the prime illustration of why an empath, once you're awake, all right, you're not going to not read energy, you always will. The important thing is that you learn how to control it, and that's the other important point. The enemy does not want God's chosen empath to ever learn how to do. The enemy, because you know why? Because once we can sense that, we know how to turn off that empathy switch. As soon as you sense that in an environment, it doesn't matter where, then the enemy knows that we will instinctively know to shut off that empathy. Because remember, it's that empathy that the narcissistic abusers have used to gain interest into your head and into your heart. And that is their goal. And they do it in a number of ways, obviously. And a lot of it starts where they try. You can sense when they're trying to tug at your heartstrings and your intuition goes, that feels not. Nope, you can feel that. Them trying to disrupt that peace. Anytime, stop and think about this. That's another way you're reading energy, because you can sense when that person, the human host of demon spirit, is trying to, whether tug your heartstring, but then it gives you that kind of an uncomfortable feeling, okay? That is what the enemy does not want anyone to pay attention to. And that's where we all got duped many times over before God woke us up. So I want everybody to keep that in mind and don't ever, ever ignore that. That uncomfortable feeling, that's part of your radar telling you, something's off, okay? Because they're trying to purposely tug at the heartstrings with that pity party, woe me kind of thing, that victim mentality that they have. So you want to be mindful. That's part of that proper discernment. It's very, very important, because that is the way the enemy loves to trick everybody into getting trauma bonded to that person, okay? But that negative energy is the thing that is the foggy, and that is that low vibration, and it is strong, okay? It can be very strong. And when it's very strong, not only do you instinctively know to turn the empathy switch off, but also you start learning how to control your energy. Stop and think about this. The enemy does not want us to be able to do that. And it's too bad, because God will teach us that regardless. There's nothing. Once God wakes us up, there is nothing that the enemy can do to stop our spiritual growth. There is nothing that the enemy can do, because we are 100% focused on pleasing the Heavenly Father. We are 100% focused on His will for us. Okay, once we're committed to God and we are walking with Jesus, there is absolutely nothing the enemy can do that's going to work. Okay, because remember, the enemy's going to try to fight like heck, as I say in other videos, to try and put you back to sleep. And that's just one example of that question, okay? Because the enemy, for whoever needs this, okay? If you are thinking, remember, the mind, okay? If you are thinking that you are, for some reason, not able to read an energy, that's the enemy trying to trick you, okay? So you just rebuke, okay? Rebuke that in the name of Jesus. Return to sender, as I like to say often, because then wherever that was coming from, and whoever was trying to project that doubt, that demon of doubt, whoever was trying to project that onto you, it has to go back to where it came from. Because God says, you know what? You resist the devil and he will flee. Okay, there's a reason God tells us that. When we commit to Him and you resist the devil, but you have to identify all the different demon spirits. That's why I bring them here to you all, because it's important. That way, once you can identify it, you'll know exactly what it is. But that's it right there. The enemy's trying to trick whoever needed that answer, trying to trick that trying to trick the empath into thinking that they're not reading any energy. We're reading energy all the time. Okay, it's just a matter of that heightened awareness, all right? Because that's the other thing the enemy does not want us to have, is heightened awareness. Because once we have that, then God teaching us all of the little things that we need to know, and how to not only just armor up, but all the things that are part of that spiritual armor that the Heavenly Father designed for us for a reason. And we learn how to control. We're always going to put out some kind of a vibe, mostly positive, okay? Empaths, look, let's face it, we're positive and optimistic being, okay? We are highly positive spiritual being, all right? So we're always going to send out, it's why the narcissistic abusers were drawn to us in the first place, you know, kind of like how a moth is drawn to light. It's the best analogy I can come up with for that one, but they are drawn to the light. And a lot of times we all learn that the reason they're drawn to us is that they want to try and shape, you know, try to suck us in and try to change us. Remember that. The narcissistic abuser always wants to try to change the empath into a narcissist. I will cover more on that in another video. But for now, that's just some food for thought, because that really is part of the whole goal of the enemy. Okay, is to try to get you to abandon God. It's plain and simple. All right, so, but that's it right there. Don't let the enemy trick you into thinking that you're not reading the energy, because God will teach you how to control it, okay? But you will always put out some kind of a vibe. But what I mean by learning how to control it is that when you walk into an environment and you see or you sense that fogginess, that stuffiness, that negative energy, then you'll, number one, again, shut that empathy switch off, because that's telling you there's demonic activity going on in that place, wherever it is. Wherever there's that heaviness, that stuffiness, and that negative energy, there, that means there's demonic activity going on there. So you're going to be encountering the demon spirits in that atmosphere, wherever it is, okay? And so you shut that empathy off and you watch. You become a watchman, all right? And you watch. And God will reveal to you exactly what demon spirits are in that environment, who they're attached to, and also he will reveal to you who the part-time ones are and who the full-blown ones are. And that is mostly the Jezebel. Remember, as I stated in another video, a human host that has the Jezebel spirit is going to have the package deal, meaning they're going to have every single demon spirit attached to them. Okay, if they've got the Jezebel, then they've got them all, okay? And it's just something to never, ever forget. But God will reveal that to you in that environment, because that's the only way that that much negative, it takes a lot of negative energy to create that fogginess and that stuffiness. It does. It takes a lot, okay? So that means that there's a bunch of demon spirits roaming about in that area. And it can be overwhelming, or seem like it's overwhelming at first, but not when you got a handle on all yourself first and foremost. You can recognize this is all part of what the enemy doesn't want also, because if he could trick you into thinking that you can't read energy anymore, all right, then he can also trick you into not learning how to turn the empathy off, and then not being able to watch and see and or hear when God is talking to you and things like that. So that's a big, big, big thing to watch out for. But you will always read it, okay? And you want to pay attention to it. Again, like I said, God will reveal everything to you in that environment, all right? And you'll know who the part-time ones are. And just for clarification, if you're new to this channel and it's your first video you're watching, what we mean by the part-time, Okay, the part-time demon spirit that are on the human host. That's usually when they only have maybe two or three, sometimes four. It just depends, okay? But cause that's different from the Jezebel. All right, just like I just said a few seconds ago. All right, the Jezebel, that is very specific, and God will show you. But I talk about that in a couple other videos, okay? And there's a lot more to go into with that later on, but I will link those in this video description for quicker access also, because it's important. There's some certain thing that you'll notice about that person, and you'll know whether they've got the, because I'm telling you, once you recognize the Jezebel, then you know. But the part-time ones are just the ones that have just, you know, they might have the demon of, let's say, for example, they might have the demon of insecurity, they'll have the demon of criticism, and they'll have the demon of anger, right? Maybe they just have those three, all right? But it still does not mean this is no cognitive dissonance here. You're still to distance yourself, obviously, okay? But it's just that discernment, so you'll know, okay, that's a part-time one, and that God will show you how to handle that. If you can't get out yet, all right, he will. Perhaps the number one thing, what God told me was zip it, okay? Because we should always zip it when we recognize demonic activity in the area anyway, all right? But that's just one thing, especially even with the full-time Jezebels, okay? We keep our business to ourselves and we move in silence always, okay? That's the number one piece of advice that I cannot stress enough. That's very important when you recognize that demonic activity, all that narcissistic abuse going on, okay? Because that is another thing about that fogginess and that negative energy, is where that is, there you're going to have narcissistic abuse, okay? That's a package deal, all right? Narcissistic abuse and that negative energy, it's a package deal. Because after all, narcissistic abuse is nothing but that negative energy. I mean, when you stop and think about it, all of the demon spirits are negative. They're extremely negative. I mean, really let that sink in. Okay, because that's the crust of it right there. And we are not empaths, we are not negative beings, okay? We're just not. We can't, it's kind of like, we don't recognize it till we get into God's reality so much. But when you do, when God wakes you up, I just want you empaths to know that you're not ever going to not read energy, okay? You're always going to be able to do that. And God needs you to do that. Okay, that is part of his protection. Remember, God's not going to put you where he can't protect you. Okay? And so when that sinks in, you'll understand. And God will show you how to control what you send out. Because remember, what you send out, you will receive also. And it goes both ways. Yeah, unfortunately. But when you recognize that negative energy, you know how to control yourself. And not react to any of the shenanigans, because there's going to be shenanigans thrown you away in any environment that got that much negative energy, or any negative energy for that matter. There's going to be shenanigans that get thrown your way. And God will, he'll teach you and show you how to handle that. And a lot of times, like I said, it's by staying silent, not reacting. And then like if it's in the workplace, you just keep it workplace related. All discussions are work-related, nothing personal. And again, I can't stress this enough, don't get personal with coworkers, okay? Oh my gosh. we all had to learn that lesson the hard way, okay? So we're not telling you that just to hear ourselves talk, okay? It's a lot of truth. And especially when you are dealing with that much negativity in an area, you'll know. And that's what the enemy doesn't want you to do. The enemy does not want you to be able to receive all the gift, the tool, and to reignite that intuition, and also to discover all of the talents that God put inside you to carry out His will. The enemy doesn't want you to do that. So he'll throw things like that your way to try and trip you up, bottom line. Okay? So again, if anybody has any further questions about that or anything else about the spiritual battle and narcissism and cognitive dissonance, drop that in the comments below or send me an email, whatever you're most comfortable with, and I will get to those as soon as I can. Sending love and light to all fellow warriors. Thank you for watching and for your support. Until next time, let's show some gratitude to the Heavenly Father, and you keep being you. In Jesus' name, amen.